In this video, we're continuing on with the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet, Solving Quadratic Equations by Factoring. So let's continue on with number 9. And if you're confused on how to factor a quadratic equation, I'll have a link in the description below in which I go over another free KutaSoftware website worksheet that deals solely with factoring. But in this case, we're going to factor to solve. So for number 9, I'm going to start by subtracting 6 from both sides. So I'll have 6n squared minus 18n minus 24 equal to 0. Now I can recognize that 6, 18, and 24 are all multiples of 6. So I'm going to divide both sides by 6. So I'll have 6n squared over 6 minus 18n over 6 minus 24 over 6. Equal to 0 divided by 6, which is 0. So this will be positive n squared minus 18 divided by 6 is 3. So minus 3n minus 24 divided by 6, which is minus 4. That's equal to 0. Now I have an a value of 1. So I can just see what multiplies to give me negative 4 and adds to give me a negative 3. So my factors of 4, that's going to be 1. Or 4, and then 2, and 2. But since 4 is negative, one of those factors has to be negative. And in order to get to negative 3, that means that negative 4 is going to be negative, since 1 minus 4 equals negative 3. So I'll have n plus 1 times n minus 4 equals 0. So in order to solve this quadratic, I'm going to see when n plus 1 equals 0, and I'm going to solve for when n minus 4 equals 0, because remember, 0 times any quantity is 0. So if n plus 1 equals 0, when I subtract 1 from both sides, that means that n is going to be negative 1. So negative 1 plus 1 equals 0, and when you multiply that to n minus 4, we will get 0. Now let's see when n minus 4 equals 0. Adding 4 to both sides, we'll get that n is equal to a positive 4. So 4 minus 4 equals 0, and when I multiply that to n plus 1, I'll get 0. So my solutions in number 9 are negative 1 and positive 4 for n. When n is equal to either of those, my quadratic is equal to 0. Or if we look at that original equation, plugging negative 1 in for n or 4 in for n, we will get 6. So negative 1, 4 are my solutions. In number 10, I'm going to add 7 to both sides in order to get my quadratic equal to 0. So 7r squared minus 14r plus 7 equals 0. Now note that 7, 14, and 7 are all divisible by 7. So I'll just divide the left-hand side and the right-hand side by 7, because whatever I do to the left, I'll do to the right. In doing so, I'll get r squared minus 2r plus 1 equal to 0. Because 7r squared divided by 7 is 1r squared, and then we're subtracting 14r divided by 7, which is subtracting 2r, and then we'll add 7 over 7, which is 1. So you can see my a value, or my coefficient of r squared, is equal to 1. So I'll be able to factor by seeing what two numbers multiply to give me 1 and add to give me negative 2. Well, that's going to be negative 1 and negative 1, because negative 1 times negative 1 equals 1, and negative 1 plus negative 1 equals negative 2. So r minus 1 times r minus 1 equals 0. Now r minus 1 and r minus 1 are the same. So when I see when r minus 1 equals 0, or if I see when the other r minus 1 equals 0, I'm going to get the same solution. So there's only going to be one solution for this quadratic, and that's when r minus 1 equals 0. So I'll add 1 to both sides to get that r is equal to a positive 1. So 1 is my solution in number 10. In number 11, I'll add 15 to both sides. That'll give me that n squared plus 8 n plus 15 equals 0. So now I'm going to see what two numbers multiply to give me 15 and add to give me 8. So those factors of 15 are 1 and 15, and 3 and 5. 3 plus 5 does indeed equal 8. So I'll have n plus 3 times n plus 5 as my factors for the quadratic, and that's going to be equal to 0. So in order to solve, I'll have to see when n plus 3 equals 0 and when n plus 5 equals 0. So n plus 3 equals 0. By subtracting 3 from both sides, I'll get that n is equal to negative 3. So when n is negative 3, n plus 3 equals 0. For n plus 5 equal to 0, I'll subtract 5 from both sides to get that n is equal to negative 5. So my solutions in number 11 are negative 5 and negative 3. Let's move on to number 12. In number 12, we're going to add 30 to both sides, and we're also going to be taking away or subtracting 11r from both sides. That way we have 0 on the right-hand side of our equation. So again, adding 30 to both sides and subtracting 11r. So we'll get that 5r squared minus 55r plus 150 equals 0. Now, each of these terms is divisible by 5. So dividing the entire left-hand side by 5 and the right-hand side by 5, 5r squared divided by 5 is 1r squared, or r squared, minus 55r divided by 5 will be 11r, and then we're going to be adding 150 divided by 5, which is 30. And that equals 0 divided by 5, which is 0. So now, since our a value is a positive 1, we're going to see what two numbers multiply to give us 30, but add to give us negative 11. So looking at the factors of 30, we have 1 and 30, and both of them will be negative in order to get a negative 11, but negative 1 plus negative 30 does not equal negative 11. So then we'll have 2 and 15, negative 2 plus negative 15 does not equal negative 11, so we'll have 3 and 10, negative 3 plus negative 10 does not, so then we'll move on to 5 and 6, and negative 5 plus negative 6, or minus 6, does indeed equal negative 11. So we're going to have r minus 5 times r minus 6. That's going to be equal to 0. So we're going to solve for when r minus 5 equals 0 and when r minus 6 equals 0. So if r minus 5 equals 0 and r minus 6 equals 0, in that first equation, I'll add 5 to both sides to get that r is equal to 5. In the second equation, I'll add 6 to both sides. So adding 6 to 0 will give me that r is equal to 6. So my solutions in number 12 are 5 and 6. Moving on to number 13, I'm going to add 3 to both sides. And at the same time, I'm going to add 5k squared to both sides. So negative 4k squared plus 5k squared is a positive 1k squared, which is k squared. And then we're subtracting 8k, and then negative 3 plus 3 is going to be plus 0. And that's going to be equal to 0. So we need to see what two numbers multiply to give us 0 and add to give us a negative 8. Well, remember, 0 times any number is 0, and 0 plus any number is that original number. So let's take negative 8. Negative 8 times 0 is 0, and negative 8 plus 0 is negative 8. So I'll have k minus 8 as one factor and k plus 0 as another factor. That is equal to 0. And you can see when you FOIL this out, k times k is k squared, k times 0 is 0, negative 8 times k is negative 8k, and negative 8 times 0 is 0. So now we're going to see when k minus 8 equals 0 and when k plus 0 equals 0. So k minus 8 equals 0 and k plus 0 equals 0. Adding 8 to both sides in this first equation, we'll get that k is equal to a positive 8. And then k plus 0 is simply k. So we'll get that k is equal to 0. So our solutions in number 13 are 8 and 0 for number 13. Plugging 8 or 0 in for k will make this quadratic equation true. And number 14, I'll subtract 3b from both sides. So I'll get that b squared plus 5b minus 3b is 2b minus 35 equals 0. So I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me a negative 35. So one of those factors is going to be negative, and add to give me 2. Well, I know that 5 and 7 multiply to give me 35, but I need to figure out which one is going to be negative in order to get a positive 2. That will be the 5. Negative 5 plus 7 equals positive 2. So I'm going to have b minus 5 and b plus 7 as my factors of the quadratic b squared plus 2b minus 35. And that is all equal to 0. So in order to solve, I know that b minus 5 equals 0, and b minus 7 equal to 0 will also solve this quadratic. So b minus 5 equal to 0, I'll add 5 to both sides to get that b is equal to a positive 5. For b plus 7 equal to 0, I'll subtract 7 from both sides to get that b is equal to a negative 7. So my solutions in number 14 are negative 7 and positive 5 for b. Now let's move on to number 15. In number 15, I'll start by subtracting 5 from both sides. So I'll have 3r squared minus 16r minus 7 minus 5 will be minus 12 equals 0. Now, I cannot simplify this, and my a is not a value of 1, so we're going to need to factor by grouping. We're going to see what two numbers multiply to give us a times c, and still add to give us that negative 16 for b. So a times c is 3 times negative 12, which is negative 36. So we need to see what two numbers multiply to give us negative 36, but add to give us negative 16. So looking at the factors of 36, there's 1 and 36, but whichever one's negative will never add up to negative 16. And then there's 2 and 18, and if the 18 is negative, 2 minus 18, that will be a negative 16. So now I'm going to rewrite this quadratic, splitting up this negative 16r. So I'm going to have 3r squared plus 2r minus 18r minus 12, and that is all equal to 0. So what I did, I just took the positive 2 and negative 18, which I know adds up to negative 16. So essentially, I just split up that negative 16 into two separate terms, 2r and negative 18r. But if we add them together, we'll still get this same exact quadratic. Those are equivalent. But now, look, I can factor by grouping. I'm going to group my first two terms together, and I'm going to group my last two terms together. However, in order to make this a little bit easier, I'm going to have this be adding a negative 18r. So we're going to add a negative 18r. Remember, these are adding together since I made this a negative 18. So I'm pulling out the greatest common factor from each. In the first grouping, that greatest common factor is r. So pulling out an r, I'll be left with 3r plus 2. And in the second grouping, I'm going to be pulling out a negative 6. So that will leave me with 3r plus 2. So now I have my two separate factors. One of them is 3r plus 2, and the other is r minus 6. But remember, this is all equal to 0. So I'll have 3r plus 2 times r minus 6 equal to 0. And that's because r gets multiplied to 3r plus 2, and negative 6 also gets multiplied to 3r plus 2. So if we were to FOIL that out, we would get the same answer. Now, if you're confused at any point during this method of factoring by grouping, I'll leave a link in the description below where I go over another free KutaSoftware website worksheet that is all factoring by grouping. So on that worksheet, I explain this process or this method more in depth. So feel free to click that link below and watch a couple of practice videos before you get into solving quadratic equations by grouping, which it's just one extra step besides factoring, which we're going to do now. Remember, any number times 0 equals 0. So that means that 3r plus 2 equals 0, or r minus 6 equals 0. So I'll solve for when 3r plus 2 equals 0. So I'll subtract 2 from both sides to get that 3r equals negative 2. And then I'll divide by 3 to get that r equals negative 2 thirds. And then I'm also going to solve for when r minus 6 equals 0. I'll just add 6 to both sides to get that r is equal to a positive 6. So my solutions in number 15 are negative 2 thirds and a positive 6. If I plug either of those in for r in the first equation, I'll get 5. And in my second equation, plugging any of those in, I'll get 0. So negative 2 thirds and 6 are my solutions in number 15. Now let's move on to number 16. And for number 16, again, we're going to be factoring by grouping. So I'll add 3 to both sides at the start. That will give me that 6b squared minus 13b plus 6 equals 0. Because my a term cannot be simplified to 1, I'm going to do a times c, which is equal to 6 times 6, which is 36. And that's a positive 36, so I'm going to see what two numbers multiply to give me positive 36 and add to give me negative 13. Well, looking at the factors of 36, we have 1 and 36, we have 2 and 18, we have 3 and 12, and we have 4 and 9. And I'll stop there because negative 4 plus negative 9 does indeed equal negative 13. So I'm going to split that term, negative 13b, up. So I'm going to have 6b squared minus 4b minus 9b plus 6. That is all equal to 0. So now I'm going to factor by grouping. I'll group my first two terms together, and then I'm going to add this negative 9b as opposed to subtracting a positive 9b and group those two terms together. Pulling out the greatest common factor from the first two terms, I'll pull out a 2b. So that'll leave me with 3b minus 2. And in the second two groups, I know I'm going to have 3b minus 2. That's what I want as my quantity within the parentheses. But in order to get 3b minus 2, I'm going to need to pull out a negative 3. So pulling out a negative 3 from negative 9b, I'll get positive 3b. And pulling out a negative 3 from positive 6, I'll get a negative 2 or minus 2. And that all is equal to 0. So now you can see my two separate factors, 3b minus 2 and 2b minus 3. So I'll have 3b minus 2 times 2b minus 3. That is all equal to 0. So I'm going to see when 3b minus 2 equals 0 and when 2b minus 3 equals 0. So writing those equations, 3b minus 2 equals 0 and 2b minus 3 equals 0. I'll add 2 to both sides in the first equation to get that 3b equals a positive 2. And dividing by 3, I'll get that b equals 2 thirds. Now, solving my other equation, I'll add 3 to both sides to get that 2b is equal to 3. And when I divide by 2, I'll get that b is equal to 3 halves. So my solutions in number 16 are 2 thirds and 3 halves. And I'll go ahead and stop this video here. Before you move on to the next video, remember to click the like button and subscribe to my channel. Continue on, where I'll go over numbers 17 through 22. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And if you need more practice with factoring by grouping before you're ready to solve, go ahead and click that other link.